Good day, students. Today we want to consider a topic titled Solving an Equation with the Use of Completing the Square Method. You can use other methods like factorization method or general equation method, but when you are told to use completing the square method, please don't use any other method. You will be penalized. We have been seeing some students trying to use other methods to solve equation or the quadratic equation, but when you do that, you'll be penalized. Is that okay? You will be strictly penalized, because they know that students always run away from completing the square method to solve the quadratic equation. But it's very simple when you follow the conditions that you need to use in solving it. Is that okay? Now, the first thing to do, you can see that you have 3x squared minus 5x minus 7 equals to 0. The first thing to look at in this question is to see that we have to remove this coefficient of x squared in the course of solving this problem. But before you remove it, let's try to take the constant to the other side, to the right hand side, before you divide both sides by 3. Okay, let's have 3x squared minus 5x equals to 0 plus 7. See that I left 3 here. I've not removed it yet. I first of all transfer the minus 7, which is the constant, to the right hand side of the equation. Okay, now 3x squared minus 5x equals 7. 0 plus 7 is 7. Now divide both sides. What we need to do now is to divide both sides by 3. Divide both sides by 3. When you divide both sides by 3, you're having 3x squared divided by 3 minus 5x divided by 3 equals 7 divided by 3. Okay? After that, let's see, 3 cancel 3, we are left with x squared minus 5 over 3 x equals to 7 over 3. Now what you need to do is to add the square of the half of the coefficient of x to both sides. Add the square of the half of the coefficient of x to both sides. What is the half of the coefficient? Just write it like this: x squared minus 5 over 3 x, okay, plus half of the coefficient of this, half of minus 5 over 3 squared. Add the square of it to both sides. 7 over 3 plus, repeat this, half of minus 5 over 3 squared to both sides. From here, you plus now off is times x squared, having x squared minus 5 over 3 x plus half times minus 5 over 3 squared equals 7 over 3 plus half times minus 5 over 3 squared. You now have x squared of x squared minus 5 over 3, x plus 1 times minus 5 has minus 5 over 2 times 3, 6 squared equals 7 over 3 plus 7 over 3 plus minus 5 over 6 squared. Now see, combine together the addition of the square at the left hand sides together, left hand side together, combine together the addition of the square of the left hand side together. Now x, since you have a minus, minus half, minus 5 over 6, you bring this x minus 5 over 6 together, and bring, since they have in common 2, you put the square outside. Bring x and minus 5 together, x minus 5, if it is plus, that is here, just say x plus 5 over 6, but since you have a negative, with x minus 5 over 6, now because you are, they are having square square, you give them 1 squared. Now 1, 2, the square will be here to combine the two together, equals 7 over 3, minus 5 squared as plus 25, and negative and negative is positive, over 6 squared as 36. We now have x minus 5 over 6 squared equals LCM, which is 36. 3 goes in 36, that's 12. Now 12 times 7. 7 times 2, 14, carry 1, 7, that's 1, 7 plus 1, 8, that's 84. I have 84 plus 36, going to 36, 1, 1 times 25, 25. I have x minus 5 over 6 squared equals 84 plus 25, that's 109. Find the square root of both sides. Find the square root of both sides. Find the square root of both sides. Now have this one. Now when you put the square root here, introduce positive negative. Positive negative means, positive and negative that we brought here means, when you have minus 2 times minus 2 will give you minus 4. It will give you 4. For example, when you have 2 times 2, addition, multiplication of positive positive sign, it give you also 4. That's why we put positive negative together. Now these two cancel this square root. You are left with x minus 5 over 6 equals plus or minus square root of 109. Okay, let's separate it. It means that square root of 109 over square root of 36. You now have x to be equals to minus 5 over 6. No, x minus 5 over 6 equals plus or minus square root of 109. is 10.44 divided by square root of 36, which is 6. You have take minus 5 over 6 to the other side. Come x equals 5 over 6 turn to positive, plus or minus 10.44 over 6. Okay. Now, since you have plus or minus here, you are going to separate them. Okay. Now, have x to be equal to 5 over 6 plus 10.44 over 6, or 5 over 6 minus 10.44 over 6. Now we have x to be equal to LCM is 6. 6 goes in 6 1, 1 times 5, 5, plus 6 goes in 6 1, 1 times 10.44, that's 10.44. Or find LCM 6. 6 goes in 6 1, 1 times 5, 5, minus 10.44. x equals 5 plus 10.44, that's 15.44 divided by 6. Or 5 minus 10.44, you have minus 5.44 divided by 6. Now, x equals, when you divide that, you're having 2.57. or minus 0.91. That's the value for x. Please take note, when I say combine together the addition of the square of the left hand side, when you say, you know, when you say plus negative, when you bring them together, x plus will still give you negative. That's why I left it as minus. Is that okay? Because when you are bringing, I say combine together the addition of the square of the left hand side, when you bring it x plus minus, it still give you negative. Now bracket it and square it. You leave this minus 5 over 3x, you throw it away. We are interested in this x squared and minus 5 over 6 squared. That's why I brought it together. Okay. This is the end of our class. Please subscribe to my channel so that I can have access to the latest video. Have a wonderful day.